Okay, everybody, good morning, good morning. I want to go over the liquidity graph trader real quick before we get rolling here. Gerald, go ahead and record this. Are you ready to go? Okay, sounds good. All right, so this is something we're going to be releasing out to you guys on the members download page. So we all know we like to grab liquidity. Everybody, good morning, good morning. So let's go over this before we have a hurricane that's coming in on us, so we're going to get prepared for that. But I want to go over a few things before the day gets started here, and I want to let you know what we're going to be doing with this software package that we'll be getting out to all you members. So we all know that after a V bottom or V top, we look for a couple trade setups. So we look for a V bottom, and then we're going to look for a liquidity grab, and then we're going to look for a momentum to carry us through. So what this software is going to allow you to do is it's going to spot the first liquidity grab after a V top or V bottom. So we know that when we're looking at the software, we're looking for V top, V bottoms when the market's in an uptrend or downtrend. So we want to look for a V bottom if we are in an uptrend. If the dual trend zone's green, green, we're looking for a V bottom. That's a V bottom. And then from the V bottom, you're going to get a push in the market. So between the V bottom, just so you understand the software that's going to be for you members, before the V bottom and MoMo 1, so there's the V bottom that comes in. We're green, green. We've done a lot of videos on this. Don't need to really go over the V bottom at all. And then we went over a lot of the MoMo 1s that come in after the V bottom. So that's the combination we look for. So that's, excuse me, that's combination we look for. We look for the V bottom to come in and then the momentum to drive price in the direction of the V bottom with the MoMo 1. So what we're going to look for then is a software that's going to be on the members download page for you that we're going to wrap up for you guys. It's a software I'm currently testing right now for all members. What we're going to do is we're going to look for the liquidity grab, the first pullback of liquidity in between the V bottom and MoMo 1. So what the market likes to do, it likes to find an accumulation level, meaning a V bottom level, if they're buying. And then it likes to pull back, the market likes to pull back, grab liquidity, and they like to drive it up to momentum, which is the markup phase. So in between there, they like to grab liquidity. So there's your MoMo 1, there's your V bottom. This is white. It's your entry levels for V bottom. Here's your entry level for a MoMo 1. So where we're going to look for the first grab of liquidity is going to be in between this area. Between this area and this area, this one the market's going to try to pull back, and we're going to look for a liquidity grab. So this is a 120-20 chart, and to show you how this looks off of a liquidity grab chart, you're going to see these spikes in price. So when you see the market pull back, so let's say this is a V bottom. Let's just say the market is in an uptrend and this is a V bottom. The cycle likes to do this on a daily basis. They like to V bottom. So that's your entry V bottom off of our yellow trigger entry to get in. Then what they like to do afterwards, they like to pull the market, they like to start running the market, and they like to pull the market back on the first liquidity grab. Now what a liquidity grab is that's when they pull price back and you see these little pullbacks in price from the open versus close. You'll see a pullback in price. That pullback in price, they're grabbing liquidity to drive the price higher. So what they're essentially doing is they are taking the counter trend money out of the market. So all those counter trend traders on these pullbacks out of the market for continuation of the upside. So for instance, if this is another V bottom that happens and you see a yellow trigger come in here, if this is a V bottom, what the software will do, it will recognize the first liquidity grab. This is today's price action on the S&P. So there's your V bottom. We got tons of videos on our website on how to trade a V bottom. There's our V bottom. The first liquidity grab, meaning the first pullback in price, deep pullback in price, is when the smart money will come in. They will take out the counter trend traders that's trying to push price against overall trend. They're going to grab liquidity at this level, bring it back up, and close it back green. So essentially what they're doing is they're pulling price back against the overall trend, taking the counters out of the market, closing it back up, and driving price higher. Now the neat thing about liquidity grabs, it can work on any time frame, any Renko size. So you can go a larger Renko size to get larger possible moves, or you can go smaller Renko sizes. This is my smaller Renko size. This is my 1-1-20-20 or 1-1-20. But you can go all the way down to even real small Renko sizes like a 1-1-5, 1-1-7 or what have you, because then you're looking for shorter moves in the market because they're grabbing liquidity. So that's the process. You have a V bottom. You'll have what's called an LG1, liquidity grab one. And then you'll get the Momo one that comes in typically right after the first liquidity grab. So the Momo ones that will fire in our room will be right around this area here for a Momo one. So this is the process or the cycle of the daily on any given market. Doesn't matter on what market you trade. But this is what we're going to look for. We're going to look for a V bottom or a V top. You look for the first liquidity grab, and then there's your Momo one. So this cycle will repeat on a daily basis. Now we have our dual trend filters to keep us on the right side of the market. Right? So our dual trend filters will keep us on the right side of the market. But that's the process. V bottom, liquidity grab, Momo one. And it doesn't matter. It's the same way on the downside. If this is a V top, and you get a yellow trigger V top there. So there's your V top candle. Let's say yellow trigger bar comes in on our other chart. Here's our LG1. That's the first liquidity grab. And your Momo one will come in right after that. Typically right around this level here. So you'll notice that even on the sells, you're trying to, the first liquidity grab happens between our VTOP and our Momo one. That's when you want to look for the first liquidity grab. So it gives you confirmation. What it also does, it lowers your stop. You'll notice on a lot of liquidity grabs, if you come in with the VTOP here, this is a 20 tick chart, 20 Renko. So the high of this candle is 20. I mean, the high of this and the low of this candle is 20 ticks in between. Well, if you look at the typical liquidity grab charts, you can do this on the strategy also. You can put your stop smaller. So you'll notice that the candle size, even though it's a larger candle size we're trading off of, your stops don't need to be the size of the overall candle, because whatever your liquidity grab is, it can just be outside that liquidity grab by a couple ticks. So if I were to look at the high and low of that candle, The high on the candle is 89.5. The close is 88.25. So 88.25, and the high was 89.5. So you have a point and a half, possibly 2 points of the high and a couple ticks outside that candle. So an 8 to 10 tick stop. It cuts your stop in half typically on the liquidity grabs because it's grabbing liquidity and it's pulling all the way through already. So depending on what Renko size you use, you can adjust your stops accordingly because your stops are going to be considerably smaller. If you look at these liquidity grab here, they're going to be smaller than your original V-top, V-bottom. Because remember, the V-top, V-bottom, this is a V-bottom, V-bottom. This is a V-top. This is a big V-bottom here. So here's a big V-bottom. So notice the candle size on the V-bottom on a 20 Renko. So there's your entry at the close. Your initial stop can be somewhere 25%, the lower 25% of this candle. Whether it be, I like 15 ticks there, 15 to 20 tick stop on a V-bottom. Well, if you notice on liquidity grab, look at the size of your candle. Your size of your candle is reduced considerably because after it closes, that liquidity grab has already taken place. That reduces stop size, and that increases reward to risk. So then when finally you get the LG1, there's your LG1. When the Momo finally kicks in on a V-bottom then up here, there's your V-bottom, there's your liquidity grab one, there's your Momo that drives price. You're already in a market that's moving up. This is yesterday when the market really started cranking. So the point is, this is the rhythm. We have a lot of videos that go over the V-bottom, that's why I don't want to get too much into the V-bottom or V-top. Just review our videos on that, and I go over it every week as far as that goes. But that starts a cycle, the V-bottom with trend. Our dual trend filters, if they're green-green, we're looking for buy V-bottom. If it's red-red, we're looking for sell V-tops. But then right after the V-bottom, let's say we're green-green on our dual trend filter, you're looking for the first liquidity grab. You want the smart money to pull back the market. Take all these counter trend traders out and resume it and close it right back green. You want that because it's confirming that that V-bottom is the accumulation phase and they're trying to mark this market up. That confirmed right here, LG1, liquidity grab one, right after a V-top. LG1 confirms our V-bottom could possibly drive the market higher. So since we possibly can drive the market higher, that close of that first liquidity grab will start this move. Now, the Momo 1 should come in right after the liquidity grab 1. This is the process, daily process. It repeats over and over and over again every single day, daily cycle. So what you'll notice is when these V-bottoms fail or V-tops fail, if you have a V-top or V-bottom that fails, go back and look and see if it had a liquidity grab. Typically, they don't have a liquidity grab. What I mean by that is this. If I get a V-bottom in the market, let me get this up here. So that's the cycle we look for. I get a V-bottom in the market, and it gives me a yellow trigger on my other chart, and it gets in. And then it just crashes the other direction and takes out that low. If you look at the majority of losses, and this is the majority of them, on V-top, V-bottom, V-tops, they don't have a liquidity grab that follows, meaning they will pull in, and you'll see price does not break any of these lows to grab liquidity. So you can see which V-bottom, V-tops possibly can drive in the market. So this first liquidity grab pullback is actually a confirmation of your V-bottom that can get rolling. Now, the best trades to lower your stops after a V bottom for confirmation of liquidity grab is ideally you want the liquidity grab and the V bottom to come real close together. The closer the better. What do I mean by that? After I see a V bottom that comes in and we get a yellow trigger entry on our other chart within three candles, you want a liquidity grab right away. I like the ones that come immediately right after a V bottom. It's got to happen real short. You don't want a liquidity grab to happen, you know, after price is all the way up here from a V bottom. You're taking too much risk. You want to see the smart money come in and start grabbing liquidity right after a V bottom, because what it does, it's a tell. It tells us that they're grabbing liquidity really quick right after a V bottom. So we all know how important V bottom, V tops are. Well, the ones that fail typically won't have a liquidity grab that happens right afterwards. They'll come up a few bars, candles, boom, 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 and then take out the lows. And when you see those happen, that's typically when the market's in a chop market or it's in between profile. The market's just oscillating back and forth. You know, if you're usually outside of HV and LVA, you get a V bottom, you're good to go. But even then, if you want confirmation, some traders like to look for a V bottom, first liquidity grab. It lowers your stop considerably because now your stop is two ticks below that liquidity grab instead of your initial 25%, because the majority of traders that trade V bottom, V top, their stop is usually the lower 25% of this candle, meaning 15 ticks to 20 ticks until first targets are off. Then they bring it up. First target one, target two are off. They can bring it up, break even plus one, and see if you can get a runner. But my point is, by grabbing liquidity, by looking for the liquidity grab after a V bottom or V top, that way, if you're in here, your stop, the candle size is considerably less. It's usually half, sometimes a quarter, sometimes 33% of this candle. So what does that do? It lowers your stop considerably if you're consistent on a consistent basis. Now, when the Momo finally kicks in, the Momo 1, what happens? It drives price. So we want to, if we want to reduce risk in getting in these trades, we want to get in early in this cycle, V bottom, LG, or Momo 1. Because then afterwards, Momo 2 comes in, Momo 3, Momo 4, Momo 5. After Momo 2, which happens around this level, that's when the market goes parabolic, and that's when you see climax buying. You get climax buying, the train's already left the station. It's gone 100 miles an hour at this level. This is what's called the parabolic move in between these levels. So this is when the train first leaves the train station. This is when it starts to accelerate, pulls back, and then you start going full speed around Momo 1. And then after Momo 2 hits in this level, when you see a Momo 3 that hits the third yellow trigger after a V bottom, V top, that's when that's full 100% maximum speed in the market. And that's when you see this market, it does a lot of liquidity grabs in here trying to get all the counters out. And you can see when they're trying to drive price. Because if you just follow this price action like this, V bottom, liquidity grab, Momo 1, if after Momo 2, when they're hitting Momo 3s like this, you see what they're doing. They're grabbing all this counter money. All that's the smart money's grabbing all these counter moves. And what do? They drive it. And then you see the market go parabolic. When it goes parabolic, you don't see any pullbacks in price. Very little. And they drive it to the upside. And this one, they drove really hard, almost 10 points, in the parabolic move to the upside. So that's the process it goes through. It goes through a V bottom, liquidity grab, Momo 1. Now, if you look on this chart, when it's going to happen on this chart then, if we're looking at it, you know, your liquidity grab is going to happen in between there. So let's find when we're trading. Let me find a trend right here. We go. So here's the overall process. You go from a failure you go from green, red, trend filter to green, green. Right after it turns green, green, we're looking for the first pullback in price. Both our trend filters are green, green. There's your first V bottom. There's MoMo 1. So what we want to look at, we want to find the first liquidity grab between here and there, because that's when the smart money is going to pull price back in between the V bottom and MoMo 1 to try to drive price higher. Now, after MoMo 1 and MoMo 2 hit, the market goes parabolic, right? And the same way on the downside. Oops. Same way on the downside, let me find a V top here. V top. So V top is the same way. That's a failure. V top. Let me find a V top here. Here's a V top. So these V tops, it's the same scenario. There's your V top. Red, red. V top. Red, red. Here's MoMo 1. And there's MoMo 1. So what we're trying to do is we're trying to short the market in between these two levels. If you're looking for a liquidity grab sell, you want to find it in between the V top and the MoMo 1.